Hey, I know I'm late on making this weekly video. Oh well. While the no weather was nice and I was feeling up to it, I needed to get as much done as I could out the yard. Then I have neighbors moving who keep giving us stuff. So, like, I had to paint this bookcase that's gonna go here, and that's why I have all these books on my bed, but I have hit the wall. And spray paint is not my friend. No matter how ventilated it is, and if I have a mask on or whatever, I still just don't do well with spray paint. So I'm banning myself from spray paint anymore. Did I show you guys a book that I'm reading right now? Hold on. This is a book I'm reading. It's hard to follow. So I don't know if I'll be reading more of his books, 'cause it's hard to follow, especially when I'm, 'cause if I'm down in bed, then I have bad fatigue and stuff, and there's a lot to follow in his books. It's good, but it's a lot to follow, like I said. If you asked me to tell you what was going on, I could tell you a few things, but characters, there's too many different ones from chapter to chapter and stuff. I can't tell you everything. So, but I haven't given up. I've kept reading it. So, alright, so I'm still alive. And I don't know if you can see, but I've got a tan on my face from working outside. But I'm exhausted. I think I've got to put preen down on my clients. I have one flower bed that I still do. And Ken, I am getting to it. I'm starting this week. I'm gonna put preen down, and then I'll go every other week and start looking to see what needs to be clipped back and pulling weeds. But this, his flower bed takes me about 15 minutes, so it fits in my window. He wouldn't care if I had to come back 50 million times to get it done. He does it for me, and then he does it for himself because he just likes for it to look good. But I think he does it mostly to help me out, mentally and stuff. So, 'cause it does help just to have one. It does. He's awesome. I have good friends. I hope I'm making sense, you guys. It's just, oh, Deb, as long as my books are on my bed, let me show you some of my antique books. I got this Bible here. And you open it up and it's, ooh, no, I'm not gonna do it one-handed. Anyways, it's very old and I got a whole bunch of old books from Canada, and then I have some books from my stepdad. I had a stepdad that was a dentist and a patriarch in the LDS Church. I've got lots of his books in there. There's some old books, cool books. I study religion, not just Mormonism. I've read the Book of Mormon 3 times. I study all religions, though. Scientology is the one religion that I just really can't grasp the concept of why anybody would fall for that. I'm sorry, but it's just. Okay, I mean it costs you ever anything to do anything in that church. But anyways, that's not the video I was making. But God, Deb, if I can get something that'll hold my camera, maybe I can show you my Bible. I think it's like 1800s or something's a date in there. I don't know. I know I have a very collectible Navy book. It's the Navy, but it's like the Bible for the Navy. And I was told it's no longer in print. It might be in my closet. Once I get the other bookcase in that neighbor gave me, it's not an expensive bookcase, but it's taller than what I had, and then I can have more of the books. Because I got books everywhere right now. I got books here, and the books that are normally on the bookcase that's over against that wall. I got books down there, books up there, and then I've got books, landscaping books, and how to be sick, and then I got
CDs everywhere too, and yet I only have the one disc CD player. My power had a brownout. Have you ever had that where like power goes out for a second and then it blew up my whole stereo? I had a 5-disc CD stereo, but now I have that one. Someday maybe I'll get another one because I used to play my CDs all night. My hypnosis ones, the ones for pain, the ones for post-traumatic stress, the ones for fatigue. They've helped a lot. I don't have my post-traumatic stress nightmares anymore. Knock on wood. And this is pine, so I'm actually knocking on wood. Alright guys, not very exciting, not very informative, but it's real. It's me, it's my life, and I don't want you guys worrying about me if I don't put up a video, so I know it doesn't matter to you guys if I'm in bed or not. You like to hear from me and know that I'm okay, the same as I like to know about you guys. Nikki Ann, drop me a video. I miss you, girl. So, she does text me back sometimes. She cracks me up. Alright guys, and keep voting for Deb so we can, is it a van we're voting to get you, Deb? A new van? The link's on my Facebook, go and vote for her so we can get her that. Yeah, I believe it is a new van, so for her wheelchair and stuff. I'm sorry, this is how it gets when you guys know why I'm explaining to you. Alright guys, loves, hugs, see ya.